An update now on the Percy Lapid murder case. The lawyer of the Mabasa family rejects the claim of former Bureau of Corrections official Ricardo Zulueta that he is not among the masterminds in the killings of the broadcaster and alleged middleman Julian Amor. Zulueta earlier told ABS-CBN News he was only framed in the killings by drug lords. But attorney Danilo Pelato is not convinced.
Wala pa po naman akong natatanggap na complaint. Bali ang na ibigay lang sa akin is yung subpoena. Wala pa pong complaint. Wala pang mga papeles po.
That shows a pattern of dilatory and diversionary tactics on the part of these parties, no? He was already given enough opportunity to submit his counter-affidavits or his affidavit, pero hindi pa niya ginawa at ngayon lang siya sumulpot pagkatapos na may pending motion for inhibition na pinail si yung boss niya, si General Bagtag.
Authorities accused Zulueta of ordering gang commanders inside the state penitentiary to kill Lapid and Villamor, supposedly upon the instructions of suspended UPO Chief Gerald Bantag. Zulueta, meanwhile, defended his absence in the investigations into the murder case.
Wala pa po naman akong natatanggap na complaint. Bali ang ibigay lang sa akin is yung...
Philippine authorities express readiness for any possible attack by rebel forces. That's after the Communist Party of the Philippines declared a 10-day period of mourning for its late founding chairman Jose Maria Sison. During this period, the New People's Army were given the go signal to mount any offensive against the government. But so far, the Philippine National Police says it has not monitored any serious or credible threats related to Sison's death or the CPP's upcoming 54th anniversary on December 26. For the military's part, spokesperson Colonel Miguel Aguilar called the CPP statement on further attacks irresponsible. The self-exiled Sison died last Friday at the age of 83 after a two-week confinement in Utrecht, Netherlands, where he has been residing since the late 1980s.
The Philippine Embassy in the Netherlands vows to help process the death certificate of CPP founder Joma Sison. Meanwhile, a public viewing of Sison's remains is being held in Utrecht until December 22 before his internment on December 27. According to the National Democratic Front, negotiator Connie Ledesma, Sison was still open for peace talks with the Philippine government prior to his death.
If there are peace talks, we continue with the peace talks. If not, we continue organizing, we continue giving education sessions, we continue our work.
Presidential Advisor on Peace, Reconciliation, and Unity Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. has called Sison's death the end of an era in Philippine history, which was defined by armed hostilities. He said, now is the time for Filipinos to unite to bring lasting peace to the country.
Authorities in China on alert as the country battles what is believed to be the first of three expected COVID-19 infection waves this winter. Pharmaceutical companies across the country have been ordered to ramp up production and delivery of key medicines. Authorities also say they've taken measures to shore up healthcare services in rural and vulnerable populations. The surge in cases comes after Chinese government relaxed its zero COVID policy. No COVID-19 deaths have been reported in the past week, but health authorities admit official figures no longer capture the full picture now that mass testing requirements have been dropped.